Bob Carey with First Trust, coming to you from First Trust offices here on the 10th of July, 2012. We are exactly one day into earnings reporting season, and we heard from Alcoa last night, and their report was kind of so-so. They didn't really say a whole lot of encouraging things about the global economy that we don't already know. The economy is still growing, but not necessarily growing all that fast. The question is, what does that mean for earnings for the rest of the major companies in the stock market? The S&P 500 is expected to actually show a very slight decline in earnings for those 500 companies for the second quarter this year compared to last year. Now, the fact is, we go back over the last 3 or 4 years and we look at the actual numbers after all the earnings come in, and we compare them to the estimates at the beginning of earnings reporting season, and there's been about a 5% differential between what companies actually have done versus what the analysts were expecting them to do. And if in fact we get another quarter like we've been getting over the last couple of years of this 5% differential, then earnings will be up in fact by about 3% in comparison to last year. So nothing all that great as far as earnings for this particular quarter are concerned. We do look ahead over the next several quarters for the rest of 2012, and you plug those estimates in, and we have about a 7.2% improvement, if you will, or an increase in earnings in 2012 for the S&P 500 in comparison to last year. So we're still growing earnings. We're not growing earnings at the kind of pace that we grew them in 2010 or 2011, but the fact is that we're kind of getting to normal. Long term, the S&P 500 companies grow their earnings by about 7 to 7.5%, depending on which time period you look at. So we had this big recovery in earnings as the economy kind of got back to normal, if you will. Yet we still have a sluggish economy at this point, which implies that companies are going to have a hard time growing earnings at the kind of pace that we saw over the last few years. That doesn't really matter all that much from our perspective. The market has a lot of catching up to do. The market right now, the S&P 500 is selling at 12 times earnings. The highest P/E ratio of any major stock market average right now on the planet is the NASDAQ. The NASDAQ is selling at about 15 times earnings, the NASDAQ composite. So we have very, very low valuations, very, very low expectations. If investors reallocate some capital, not necessarily a lot of capital, but just enough capital over the next couple of years, we should see some improvement in valuations in the stock market. Valuations in our, from our perspective, are simply too low. The Fed's accommodative, interest rates are low, tax rates are the big variable, if you will, in this market, as well as government spending. Those are really the biggest issues of the day. It's really not a surprise that over the last couple of years that policy, government spending, taxes, those really have been some of the main reasons why investors have told me why they are not investing in the stock market. So we think ultimately the pressure is building on the political class, if you will. Political leaders around the world, I think, realize that 8% unemployment is not acceptable, and it's likely to result in voters throwing you out of office. And so we'll have to see, obviously, if that happens here at the end of the year. But the fact is, stocks are cheap. We do expect that the vast majority of companies will beat their earnings estimates over the next couple of weeks. A couple sectors of note, if you will, within the S&P 500, the two highest earnings estimates as far as growth is concerned from a sector perspective are the industrials companies and the technology companies. We love those two particular sectors of the market. We like them from a valuation perspective. They continue to grow earnings at a very healthy, above average rate, and we think investors are greatly undervaluing these franchises, most of the major companies in that part of the stock market. So we continue to like the more cyclical areas of the marketplace, but in particular technology and the industrials. So we like those sectors quite a bit. Anyhow, as always, feel free to check back with us next week. We will be talking a little bit more details. We'll hear from the major banks, some of the major banks later this week, and so we'll have lots to talk about then. So in the meantime, have a good week. Thank you.